students of 4th standard, we have started the lesson, that is lesson number 2, the interrelationship between the living things. Today we are going to see one of the, you can say, new point here. See here, we keep animals in order to safety some of our needs. Whenever we keep, we take care of the animals because they fulfill our needs. They become very dear to us. They become very dear to us. We look after them well. Whenever we are rearing the animals, we look after them well. We feed them well. We take them to a vet if they fall ill, we take them to the veterinary doctor. These animals too, in return, our affection. They also in return give us affection. We get milk, meat, eggs and several other things from the animals. Some animals are useful carrying the burdens on their, you can say, drawing carts. There are some drawing carts, there are some, you can say, animals which are carrying the luggage on their backs also. Domestic animals are also used to help with the heavy farm work in the fields. The domestic purpose, the animals whichever are used for the domestic purpose, they are used in the agricultural field. Dogs guard our houses. Dogs, what they do? They guard our houses. The ships gives us wool. Then see, the ships gives us wool. See in your textbook, there is, do you know? Even the excreta of the domestic animal is of a use of a human being. Human being also use the excreta of the animal. The dung of the cattle is used to do the dung cakes. They are combustible. They are used in the places as a fuel. When they burn, they give out smoke. A combustible gas, which is called as a gobar gas, that also we are getting from the dung of the cattle. That is too, it is used as a fuel. It burns without smoke. Cattle dung is also used for plastering the, you can say, mud houses. We can plaster the mud houses with the help of the, you can say, cattle dung also. Manures made from cattle dung. Manures made from the cattle dung and sheep pellets are good for, you can say, plants. They are used for the, you can say, plants. Farmers use them for growing the crops. Then see next one. Just, what is given, see here. Just as we need animals, we need plants too. Thus, as we need animals, the plants are also useful for us. Plants give us food grains. The food grains, whichever are available in the market, these we are getting from the plants. Then we also get the vegetables, then fruits. These all things we are getting from the, you can say, plants. We love flower to use them for many different purposes. We get flowers from the, we also get flowers from the plant. We also get cotton wool from the, you can say, cotton wool from the plants, whichever we are using it to make the clothes. See here further, we grow plants that are useful to us methodically. We sow seeds, we make sure that they get water. We give manure when necessary. We spray pesticides if they are attacked by insects. What we are doing, see, whenever we are growing the plants, what we are doing, first we are sowing the seeds, then we are watering it, then we are giving manure if necessary. Then see, we are also spraying the pesticides, and as they should not be attacked by the insects. Plants too give to us abundantly. They also satisfy our need. Other, you can say, living things also get their food from the environment. There are other living things also which are getting the food from the environment. For example, chameleons eat insects when they are hungry. Whenever you see that the chameleons also eat insects when they are hungry. Some snakes eat mice and frogs. There are some snakes which are eating mice and frogs. Tigers eat deers. The tigers eat the deers. The goats and sheep eat the leaves of the plant. The goats and sheep, what they are doing? They are eating the leaves of the plant. Cattle also eats the grass. Then see the new term, whichever is arboreal. Arboreal it is called. This word is nothing but it is a word of a Latin, or it is a Latin word which means tree. That means, what does this tells us? Those who are living on the trees, they are called as a arboreal. Then see, animals like monkeys or squirrels, they are living on the trees. It has some advantages to live on the trees because they are on the height, and it is better defined themselves, that they are sure that they are, you can say, free from the enemies, or they themselves can protect from the enemies. Beside this, they can eat the fruit of the trees. As they are on the trees, whatever the fruits are there on the trees, they can eat it and satisfy their hunger. So they are present on the, you can say, trees, and they are called as a arboreal. Then see, unknowingly they help the tree with whose support they live. They also help the tree with whose support they are living. As they move around here and there in the surrounding, they spread the seeds of the food. What they are doing? They are spreading the seeds of the fruit, that whatever they have eaten, the fruits that whatever they eat, they spread the, you can say, seeds of this fruit through the, you can say, droppings. Because of this, new trees can grow in an different places, or you can say in the different region. Some types of birds too are present there, which are present on the trees. They are building their nest on the trees, and they are also, you can say, useful to, you can say, spread the seeds of the fruits from one place to the another place. An egret rides on a buffalo back. See, what does this tells us? Do you know it is? When a buffalo is grazing in an grassy, grassy area, you are likely to see an egret riding on the, you can say, back. That means an egret is sitting on the, you can say, back of the grazing buffalo. What could be the reason for that? Have you ever thought what is the reason for that? A certain kind of a egret feeds on the different kinds of insects. There are some insects which are sitting on the buffalo, and these insects are taken as a food by the egret. So grass is full of kinds of insects. Now see, whatever the buffalo is grazing the grass, that grass is full of the insects. But because they are hidden in the grass, the egret cannot see them and catch them. So what happens? They come as the buffalo treads on the grass. It frightens the insects which fly over the, you can say, out of the grass. What happens? As the buffalo is, you can say, grazing the grass, the insects whichever are sitting into the grass, or whichever are hiding into the grass, they get afraid and they come out. And thus the egret which is sitting on the back of the buffalo can without mistake, it is swooping down to catch and eat them. Then it is what it is doing? It is catching that insects and it is eating. Then see next one, seasonal changes in the living thing. What is the Maratha name of mango blossom? It is called as a mohar. In Marathi it is called as a mohar. When do mango trees blossom every year? They blossom where? In the winter season. Then see, does the banyan have leaves throughout the year? No. Then see, we see frogs wherever? During the rains. Everywhere during the rains. Where do they disappear in the summer? No. They are not seen in the summer, but they hide into the, you can say, rocks. Then which is the season of the jamuns? The season of the jamuns is nothing but in the summer season. So we are having three seasons. Which are the three seasons? They are nothing but summer, rainy and winter. It is very hot during the summer. So whenever there is a summer, it is very hot. So we wear a cotton cloth during the, you can say, during the summer day, or we drink a plenty of water during the summer day. In the rainy season, we use raincoat, we use umbrellas. Different kinds of raincoats are available in the market. We are using that raincoats and hoods to avoid getting wet in the, you can say, rain. In the winter, we wear the woolen and other warm clothes to protect ourselves from the, you can say, cold. Just as three seasons affect us, they affect all other living things too. We see that there are taking place, the changes are taking place in the living world every year after. You know that there are three types of seasons. These three seasons are playing a very important role in our life. They are affecting our life, or you can say the living world too. So there are the changes brought in this living world too, year after the year. Winter in Maharashtra is also called as the season of pangal, that is falling of, you can say, leaves. That is because many trees shed their leaves in the winter. In the winter season, what happens? Many of the trees, they are shedding their leaves. So this season is called as a pangal in Maharashtra. The coats of many furry animals become thicker in winter. What happens? The coats of the furry animals which are having fur on their body. So that becomes thick in the winter. This keeps them warm in the cold season. Such growth of hair is especially noticeable in animals like sheep and some types of goats and rabbits. Whenever you see, whenever there is a winter, the coat, or you can say the furry animals, their fur increases because they have to protect themselves from the, you can say, from the winter. So growth of hair is seen in these animals. That animals are sheep, you can say goats or rabbits. The end of the winter is also time of the, you can say, mango trees to start the, you can say, blossoming. Then see, whenever there is an end of the winter, that is the time of the mango tree to blossoming. Or these blossom are called mohar in Marathi. At the close of the month of the February, what happens? See, it becomes more warmer, because the March is going to come and we feel heat in those days. So that is the, you can say, days of the summer. Then see, in these days or in this season, many trees are getting the new leaves. Forest appears to be taken on a copper color because the leaves are reddish and shiny. while they are tender. Or you can say, whenever you see the, you can say forest region, the forest region appears copper color because here the reddish leaves are, you can say, seen on the plants. Then see, their color changes to green as they grow bigger and bigger. Then see, the call of the quail is also heard in the, you can say, many places. In summer, the market is full of mangoes and watermelons. Whenever you see, in summer, there is a market which is full of, you can say, mangoes and watermelons. So we can buy the mangoes and watermelons during the summer season. So this is the season of the fruits. So mango trees grow all over Maharashtra, especially in the Konkan region. They grow very well and it is famous for the, you can say, mangoes. It is also the season of the cashew nuts. The summer is also the season of the cashew nuts. The red yellow cashew apples can be seen growing on the cashew trees on the hillsides in the Konkan region. So what we see, the cashew fruits also grow in the Konkan region. See here next one. In June, the black clouds make their appearance. Whenever we see, in June, the black clouds has their appearance. The rainy season comes there. It is the time of the, you can say, rainy season. Now here the jackfruits, the jamuns, or you can say karvandas, they also begin to come there. The seeds of the grass and other plants lie scattered all over the ground. Then see, they sprout and start growing as soon as it begins to rain. Whatever the seeds that are fallen onto the ground due to the rain, they starts to sprout. It becomes green everywhere. Whenever you see, it becomes green everywhere. And the greenery is seen in the hot summer months. Sometimes we can even see the rainbow with the seven colors in the sky during the summer seasons. Whenever there is a rain for a short time, we see the rainbows of the, you can say, rainbow of the seven colors also. As it becomes wet everywhere, now the frogs appear. What happens? The frogs appear. We also hear the sound of the frogs. And what the frogs are doing? They are croaking. They are croaking. And all together, they are croaking. As the rainy season ends, it is time to winter to make a comeback. It is colder and colder. This is not good for the frogs. So they go deep under the ground for a long period of slumber, and which lasts for 7 to 8 months. They go deep into the ground and stay there for 7 to 8 months. We depend on agriculture for food. The different seasons, or you can say summers, winter and monsoon, these are different tasks. These are having the different tasks in the field. We are growing the different crops for the different seasons in the field.